Good morning, students. We all know that the famous Einstein's mass energy relation, that is E equals mc square. See, in classical physics, mass and energy are considered as different quantities. Accordingly, there are two conservation laws. One is conservation of mass and conservation of energy. In the relativity, mass is also treated as a form of energy. Energy in any one form can be converted into another form. See, energy can be converted into another form of energy, which means energy in the form of mass can be converted into some similar forms of energy such as heat, light, kinetic energy, etc. And hence, there is only one conservation law in relative physics. This law of conservation of, this is law of conservation of mass energy. And equivalence of mass energy is expressed by Einstein's energy equation, that is E equals mc square. Here, where E represents the energy, that is equivalence of mass m, and c is velocity of light. From the figure, see, from the expression E equals mc square, if energy is more, see, it is directly proportional. Energy is more, mass is also more. And c is constant, that is velocity of light. Its value is 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. Here there are two important laws. One is conservation of mass and another one is conservation of energy. Here first form, mass is also treated as form of energy. Energy in one form can be converted into some other form, like it means that energy in the form of mass can be converted into familiar form of energy such as heat energy, light energy, kinetic energy, and potential energy can be converted into kinetic energy. Here only one difference is the one conservation law, that it obeys relative physics. And another factor is relativity of mass. We know that according to relativistic analysis, mass of a body depends on its velocity. If m naught is the rest mass of the body and m is the mass while moving with velocity v, and it can be shown that mass m, that is m equals m naught divided by square root of 1 minus v square by c square. And rest mass, that is m naught. And relative mass, that is m. Here rest mass, as the name indicates, that mass of the body when it is at rest position or stationary frame of reference. And relative mass is, it is a moving frame of reference. Here mass of the body while in motion, that is in a moving frame of reference. And inverse velocity addition theorem. See, we have one expression, that is u dash equals like just a minute that is u dash equals u minus v divided by 1 minus v by c square u. Here for a frame s dash which is moving with velocity v with respect to s, it means s is moving with velocity minus v with respect to s dash, and inverse velocity which is in opposite direction, that is inverse velocity addition theorem. Even in the limiting case when u dash equals c, when u dash equals c and v equals c, we get u equals c. Hence we conclude that the addition of any velocity to velocity of light yields only velocity of light. So in other words, velocity of light is invariant under the transformation law, and so it is impossible to exceed the velocity of light. Thus the velocity of light is the same for all inertial observers, that is u dash equals c minus u, which is not true in the case of light. Here classical addition is not true for light. Nature cannot behave differently for different phenomena. Hence laws of physics must remain the same for all inertial observers, that is second postulates of special theory of relativity. See, this is the discussion of these topics today, that is mass energy relations in these two concepts, conservation of energy and conservation of mass, and relativity mass, relativity of mass and rest mass, relative mass, the difference between rest mass, relative mass and inverse velocity addition theorem.